quick impromptu decision. I've decided to just get the lips. What are we doing?
Enhanced.
Enhanced. What are we using?
So we're using Juvederm, which is a elegant type of product. What we're going to do today is just redefine a little bit of the borders of the lip and perhaps just add a tiny bit of volume. Mm-hmm. All very natural.
Yeah.
Maintaining the beautiful shape of your lips.
Because we did something in August last year, really subtle, nobody even noticed, which is what we wanted. But now we're just ready to give it a little bit more volume.
Do you want to be stressful?
Yes, please. Stressful. Oh, yay. Okay, it does hurt a little bit.
Is that working? So with lip fillers, it's very common to get bruises. Kelly was very lucky last time that she only got a tiny little bit of bruise. So hopefully this time it will be the same. Mm-hmm. So the lips is a highly vascularized area. It will be impossible to inject on the lips and not make you bleed.
Okay.
Yeah. So we always expect a little bit of bruising. So if you want to have this treatment done, we usually recommend to do not close to an event or anything that you've got coming up quite soon.
How long does the swelling last?
Swelling can last up to 5 days. Most commonly is the first 3 days that you get the most swelling and then it settles down. So usually the day after can look worse than on the day that you injected.
Is there anything I can't do?
We recommend not to exercise, okay? Mm-hmm. Avoid applying makeup straight away. I'm gonna massage and make sure that I'm gonna use Vaseline and massage so your lips will be well hydrated, mm-hmm. not sunbathing. It will be the usual as you would do for Botox. I'm just gonna massage and then mm-hmm. you have a look. The shape is nice.
Yeah, the wrinkles are gone.
I would suggest not to massage. It will feel where the product is on the first few weeks and then it will just smooth and blend with your skin. So I don't suggest you massage today, mm-hmm. okay? But after, from tomorrow, if you do feel any little lumps, mm-hmm. what you can do is just, as I'm doing, apply a little bit of Vaseline mm-hmm. and foam pressure and just distribute the...
So you're doing it from the inside?
Yeah, inside and outside, yeah. Just like that.
Okay.
So if you feel where the product is, just give a good squeeze mm-hmm. and just even out. Look at that.
Oh, yeah. It looks lovely.
Do you like it?
Yeah, love it. I just love that it's instant. Like, you get to see it straight away.
Yeah.
Let's see if anyone noticed. My husband, my children, nobody noticed last time. So, let's see. Well, I'm home, end of the night, and I thought I'd just quickly show you how the lips are looking. Funny story, I came home, I'd had my Botox, I've got no makeup on, and of course I decided today to get my lips done. And so, you know, to me they're very swollen. I've got a bruise, quite a big bruise here, which was unfortunate, but it happens. And I come home and it's now 8:45 at night, and I got home at like lunchtime. No one said a word. Not one family member even noticed, which I guess is good. But even then my husband, at the end of the night, we're in the kitchen, he went, oh my love, you've got a little bruise. I was like, yeah, Botox bruise. Clearly he doesn't know where I get Botox in my face. And he goes, oh. I'm thinking, he's looking right at my lips and he didn't even notice. How can you not? Anyway, they're swollen and I love them now, but I know when they go down, I keep looking at them. I think they're going to look great. I might want to put a little bit more in. I can hear you all going, don't. But I know what happened in August and my body just loved the hydration and sucked all the product out and left me with nothing. That's the end results of me getting lip filler officially for the first time. Now remember, I didn't do this to change the look of my lips or the look of my face. I did it to iron out the lines, and for me it's prevention. But this sort of procedure can make or break your face. I know that sounds really harsh, but it can. So please make sure you go to a reputable medical practitioner. If you live in the UK, the only person I recommend, highly recommend and use, of course,
is Dr. Julia. I'll put Dr. Julia's details in the description and also in this video. So remember, I make lots of other videos based around beauty, and I've been paleo for about 10 years now. So I share all things paleo on my YouTube channel. So please subscribe. And if you've enjoyed this video, please give me the thumbs up. And if you'd like to be notified when my next video comes out, just click on the notification bell. I'll see you in my next video.